Hi, my name is Kaylee Thompson, and today we're going to be talking about Milton Bradley, pioneer of the board game industry. In 1860, Milton Bradley, he was just a 24-year-old guy in Springfield, Massachusetts. While living in Springfield, he ran a lithography business. Lithography is basically just an old printer. Instead of the painter like making this picture over and over again, oh my god, so much time, it would just make the picture instantly. You'll have hundreds of copies so much sooner. But the lithograph was expensive. Milton?
Yep.
Milton Bradley had these lithographs of Abraham Lincoln, but he doesn't have the beard yet. This is a picture of him without his beard. Milton Bradley thought this was a great idea. Oh my god, I am so smart. Like, everyone loves Abraham Lincoln, but like, I'm gonna make a picture of him, so like, I would get rich, and like, everyone will love me, and I'll be like, famous, and like, TikTok famous, stuff like that. And they're selling like hotcakes. Meanwhile, this little girl from Westville, New York, named Grace Bedell, writes to Abraham Lincoln. She says, "If I was a man, I would vote for you. But I'm not. I'm a girl. So what? You need to grow a beard. Because women love whiskers. So if women tell their husbands that they like you, they'll vote for you and you'll get more votes." So Abraham gets this letter and he says,
"Notice anything different about me? I got a beard, baby. Isn't this cute?"
So everyone gets drawings of Abraham Lincoln in the newspapers. But now he has this big beard. People with their lithograph. I spent $10 on this lithograph of Abraham Lincoln. This is fake news. I thought I was gonna get this handsome, beautiful man without his beard, but then he grew a beard? Like, what the heck? I spent $10. You know how much money that is? A lot. Milton Bradley is very distraught. He wasted most of his ink on these lithograph photos, and he burns the rest. Milton Bradley says,
"I have this lithograph machine. It's a big hunk of junk now. I don't even have a good picture to print. What am I gonna do?"
So he meets with his best friend George, and they're playing this Puritan game. So he realized during the game, I can make a better game than this. I can make a game for everyone, not just Puritans. And it's gonna be amazing. He calls his new game the Checkered Game of Life. It was kind of like Chutes and Ladders, where virtuous qualities like honesty, bravery, and perseverance sent you upward, and idleness, cowardice, and being judgmental sent you back to the bottom of the board. George is so excited about this new game. They really didn't have that much to entertain themselves with. Oh my god, so this game is amazing. It's not boring at all. Like, you can be like rich and famous again if you like give this to the world and like make entertainment out of it, because our lives suck. They're so boring. Milton Bradley goes to New York City and tries to sell his game. "Hey everybody, I have this new game. It's American, not just Puritan. It's super cool. Everyone is buying it." Oh my god, I can't wait to go home and play this new game. Like, OMG. Like, it's gonna get, like, I'm gonna be, like, win this game and you're gonna lose because I'm better than you. He sells over 40,000 copies in one weekend. Then trouble hits him again because the Civil War happened, like, the next day. People are buckling down. Oh my god, the war's happening and I can't play this awesome game that I beat Jessica in because, like, the war is happening, and I'm like, I have no time. I need to look great for the soldiers just in case I get, like, a boyfriend. Milton Bradley has to think his lithograph again. Soldiers have a lot of downtime between their battles. I'm going to make these games really tiny so soldiers can fit them in their pocket. And the second they're bored, they can play. Not only does he reduce the size of the game, he makes the game compatible for checkers, chess, backgammon, and his checker game of life. What a brilliant idea! And a bunch of charities bought them to give them to the soldiers. And the soldiers were like, so cool, someone thought of us for once. I'm so happy that I have something fun to do instead of just watching my friends die. Like, that's not fun. So we're gonna play this game and we're all gonna have fun with jazz hands. Eventually, the war ends and everyone has time to play games again. He starts selling them super fast. He even comes up with more games and they become really popular, just like Charlie D'Amelio. Milton Bradley develops the Milton Bradley Company, which becomes responsible for bringing Candyland, Guess Who, Battleship, Twister, etc. to the public. And fun facts, in the dimensions of board games, even to this day, are 18 by 18, because that's the size of the cardboard that fits inside his lithograph machine. His manufacturing company is closed now in Springfield. He was such an important local figure. There's an elementary school named after him, and kids still go there today. And the crazy thing is, 100%, none of it would have happened if Abraham Lincoln didn't grow his beard.
All right, Cammie, what are some of your favorite board games?
I like Pictionary. And I really like Guess Who. He made it. So cool. I like Choking Hazard. That's a good game. And I like Twister. Also made by him. And yeah, that's kind of it.
Okay. Is there a reason why you wouldn't like board games?
It has the word boring in it. Duh.
High five.
Yay.
You did it.